took me 5 years to attain my fish tank after my mom's disastrous experience when she was doing her high school science project with her fish tank because she lost all of her fish and she didn't want that to happen to me either. After two algae explosions in my tank, I decided that it was time to find a more efficient way to clean my fish tank. So I will show you how I do that. First, you always want to check your pH. This is a pH solution set that you can get at Petco or any other fish store. You measure out the water to the white line that's right here in the glass from your fish tank, obviously, or else you won't be checking the right pH. You drop in 3 drops into the glass and you shake it up and it turns color. You then set it to this little tester sheet, and mine is between 7.1 and 7.5, which is your pH that your fish tank should be for freshwater fish. Your temperature should also be between 78 to 76 degrees. If it gets too high, you might boil your fish on accident. You then take these magnetic cleaners to clean the glass, which are really, really handy. You place the yellow one inside the glass, and you place the green one on top of it, and you just grab this and slide it all around the glass extremely easily. And sometimes when you're trying to go around the corners, I don't take it out, but it's probably better to take it out and put it on again, because I've almost squished a fish a few times. Then you change the filter. That's about a month's worth, because my sucker fish died and I didn't know. So it got really gross. So that's a dirty filter. That is what a clean filter should look like. It has the black in it because charcoal helps to clean the fish tank and clean the water and make it more clear. I have an in-tank filter, so it sets all the way in the tank instead of having the back part hang out. You just slide in the filter between this little black thing that's right here. And then when it's all the way in, it should look like that. And this also has a black filter on top of it that you don't change. You can clean it, wash it in the sink if you want to, if it's gross. Your filter should be changed once a month, and that's when you should do your halfway water change. This is a fish safe cleaner, and you spray it on a little sponge that is a filter sponge that you can get a sheet of. It's really cheap. You then spray that onto there and clean around where your sucker fish can't get, which is basically that black room and wherever the water doesn't go up to. And then it's gross. You can also clean this top part because it gets a lot of calcium build up on it from the water that splashes up from the filter. You wipe that off. I use toilet paper or something because the little foam sheets don't really get all the stuff off the glass as well. And then, once again, it gets all that gut. I don't even know how gross, how all that stuff gets on there. It's just gross. Then you take a 5-gallon bucket, and this is a vacuum hose to help drain the water out. Mine's old, so it has some stuff on it. You clip that to the side of the bucket with the clip and put most of the hose inside of the bucket. You then set it in your fish tank and you pump it up and down until the suction starts. And I have a clear fish in here, so it's hard to see him. He's right here, actually. So you want to make sure it's in the gravel so you don't suck them up. It's, you can't get them back after that. You then empty your water about halfway. I do a little less than half, or I mean a little more than half, just because I don't want to change the water temperature too much. And then you start filling your water. Now I usually fill my tank up to about here. I don't know why, but I don't want them to jump out of the top, I guess. That's too close. that's it, filled up. You can also take your plants out and wash them, but I had a separate fish, so I didn't do that because I want her to be able to eat off the plants and not die from starvation. My suckerfish died, and I can't keep any of them alive. I've gone through 7. So I got snails. This one's much, much bigger. It's a different type of snail, and I have a little black dog. They work really cool. Pretty cool. And then this is just a quick video of what your tank will look like after you've cleaned it. And this right here, I have 2 shrimp. There's one here and one over there, and they're pregnant, so they're in a birthing tank. See, I have a lot of plants and decorations because the fish I have like hiding spaces because they are really small. And I used to have bigger fish and they would want to hide because I've had a goldfish that I rescued from a feeder tank eat all of my fish before. It was the worst fish expense I've ever spent on a fish. It ate $20 worth of fish. So I brought him back to the fish shop. Now your tank is ready for your cats to enjoy.